All right, Leonard Skinner is up next. That smell, gross. All right, here's...
I know, it's such a weird title for a song.
There's so many things that come to mind when I say that. AJC4691 a year ago said, no idea that in a 3 months, in 3 months and 7 days, their lives would change forever. Wow. R.I.P. Leonard Skinner. A. Rubin 2 years ago said, very cool to have that color added in. I thank the poster and the maker of this color.
Wait. Go ahead. I was just setting up the video.
I thank the poster and maker of this color version. Remember, this is the last tour. And in 1977, there is so little footage. To see this period is truly rock history. Smedley Butler said, that smell was amazing. That's so weird. Paul J. Boussard, 4 months ago, said, three of the best guitarists ever.
Yeah, these guys, I saw behind the music with these guys. They died, like, half the band died in a plane crash. In like 1978.
Unbelievable.
Holy shit. Then 1977. So this is, oh, that's sad. It's called The Road Home. Jeez. So yeah, this is like literally rock history here. All right. On that very positive note, it's in the 1935 mark. Let's go to 1935. Well, we'll do 1925. How's that? All right.
This is a brand new number. It's going to be out on a new album. Be out in September. It's called That Smell.
Thank you.
Just one more big slug might do the trick. Want a hell of a price for you to get your kicks.
Hell yeah! Ooh, that smell! Can't you smell that smell? Ooh, that smell! The smell of death around you.
Selling our formula officially. It's amazing stuff from Europe.
Made in Germany.
Sold in America.
Highest standards there are. In America, the standards haven't been updated since 1980. Super weird, like older than me. In Europe, they update safety standards basically every year. This formula is top notch, great for the stomach, great for constipation. This is a great product. If you happen to want to purchase it and join us on our journey, then grab the link in the description. If you do and leave a review for us, send me a screenshot at vinandstory@gmail.com of your review after you have received the product. We will put your name in a hat. Song reviews are going to come out by some of the people that have left reviews. Don't forget to send us a screenshot of your review once you get the product. Now a word from our mascot dressed as a pirate, Fuji.
The steal of a deal.
Damn, bro.
What an important song, though.
Damn.
What a really important song.
And then, like, 3 months later, not everybody died, but a bunch of them died in that plane crash.
I wonder if, obviously, I've never shot up anything, but when you go to the hospital, have you ever had them put that, were you ever, like, dehydrated and they put that drip?
Yeah.
Okay, so, oh yes, that's true, yes.
I was pretty dehydrated.
Yeah, but you were probably so far gone at that point that you wouldn't have even realized that there's like a smell. Did you smell something? When they put it in your arm?
That was hallucinating.
Yeah, yeah. I figured that much. I figured you wouldn't. Well, when they put this.
I didn't collapse. I went 3 days once without drinking water. And,
Yep, he did.
I didn't collapse or anything, but I was definitely.
I wasn't there.
I was definitely hallucinating. And they yelled at me, but you know, whatever. But go ahead. What were you saying? Yeah.
So but you're not gonna know this, but when they put that drip in your arm and it starts, like within a few moments, you smell this weird smell.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And so when he says, "Can't you smell that smell?" and he says, "The smell of death surrounds you," I wonder if when you shoot up, if you also smell something of the drug that you just put into your stream.
Oh, I see. Because when you do something intravenously, it has some.
However, it gets. I think it's weird that it happens, but it does. My thought was, oh, I wonder if he's trying to, you know, like he comes up with this song to connect that scent to death for them. So that way people might be like, whoa, wait a minute. this smell could, because he said, like, the person basically says, like, I'll be better tomorrow.
Yeah.
And he's saying, you don't know if tomorrow's even going to come for you.
Right, right. That's what he says.
Such, like, an important song. I wonder how many people this song helped.
Hey, you're a fool. Go on, stick those needles in your arms. You're a fool. You're just a fool. Yeah, it looks like they wrote the song as a precautionary tale to about drug use and the sex, drugs, and rock and roll lifestyle. It's just horrible that... And I guess they had gotten into a car accident. They had gotten into a car accident earlier.
Holly
what?
Shade said, yeah, you can smell it. You can also taste it, too.
Oh,
that's
when something...
That's what I figured, yeah.
Oh, yeah, intravenous. Yeah, so that's probably what it is. I mean, you're right. I didn't really smell anything.
Yeah, you're...
I was like, you know, in a very interesting situation. But, yeah. So, yeah, it does have a smell for sure. But they had just gotten into a car accident, like, prior. And they made it out okay. And so I guess it made him look at his mortality. And so that's where the song came out.
Oh.
Yeah, but and then 3 months after this, they die in a plane crash.
What the fuck?
So,
that's so crazy. Wait, they got in a car accident and then three years
They got into a car accident. The car accident was the impetus for this song because, I'm assuming you had to face your mortality after that. So,
oh my goodness.
It's one of those things where it's fascinating to me because I grew up in a certain form of Christianity where people believed you could speak things into existence.
Mm-hmm.
And so we came up in a, sometimes, I mean, no disrespect to my mom, but I always thought that was superstitious. Like, I idolized my mother and all the rest of it, but I never really believed that stuff, that you could speak things into existence, whether good or bad. And my mother would always say, you have to be careful about what you say. You're going to bring that on you, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, and they would tell us you couldn't speak stuff into existence, and they would kind of like mock that thought process. But at the same time, they would tell you don't say anything out loud because the devil can hear you. So don't say your fears out loud.
Yeah, yeah.
Just, so the idea was still there.
Yeah, yeah. And I'm like, man, that's nonsense. That's part of our Pentecostal subculture. But now, I listen to Colin Cowherd. He's a secular sportscaster. And for the last couple of weeks, they've both been using that phrase, speaking things into existence. So now that idea has become mainstream. There is this book/video called The Secret. And The Secret is about speaking things, and it's called the, quote, law of attraction. Mm-hmm. So where you believe and you speak things onto yourself to manifest the future. And mm-hmm. so, and obviously they're saying you need to do that positively, but the other side, the dark side of the quote law of attraction is that people bring negativity to themselves too by what they speak. And so there are some ironies in music. So for example, Big makes this record Ready to Die.
Mm-hmm.
And then his second record is Life After Death. So and in on the Ready to Die album cover, it's Biggie when he was a baby.
Mm-hmm.
On the Life After Death album cover, it's Biggie outside of a hearse. Well, Big died before the Life After Death record came out.
Yeah.
And I remember my mom saying, he just called all his death onto himself. I mean, obviously, what do you think is going to happen? Same thing with Tupac. He was always singing about his death. I wonder if heaven's got a ghetto. So my mom was like, he called that thing onto himself. And so I still don't believe that. Although I will say, there's nothing in the Bible that could convince me that something like that is real. But this is the irony. There are certain scientists
that are making you wonder.
That make me think,
yeah.
Well, particularly Don Hoffman.
Mm-hmm.
Particularly Don Hoffman. Because if you look at conscious agents theory, he starts off by saying that consciousness is fundamental and not matter, and that the reason that you see the moon is because you're looking at it, you're essentially, and he explicitly said this on the Lex Fridman show, you should watch it. I'll put the link in the description, because I make a lot of references to Don Hoffman. One of these days, I might do a special on Don Hoffman, actually, because I talk about him all the time. I might do that. One of these nights when I'm staying up till 6 or 7 in the morning, I'll just do a Don Hoffman, because Don Hoffman did about 2 or 3 hours with Lex Fridman. I think that's his name. So I might just do that to give people some context for my worldview. But so here's the idea. If we are conscious agents who then are manifesting the physical world by what we see and what our expectations are. You expect the moon's going to be there, so you look and boom, there's the moon. But when you look away, there's no moon. That's Hoffman's theory. And he's proven it mathematically.
That's weird.
It's so fascinating. And you can tell, in the discussion that Hoffman is disturbed by these revelations. There is a specific point in the broadcast where he's really disturbed. My point is, I am not sure. We don't still yet understand the correlation between consciousness and our experience in the quote real world. So because we don't have that fundamental understanding down yet from a scientific perspective, I am not exactly sure that there isn't some, now listen very closely, not mystical, but scientific connection between what we say, what we sing, and the quote real world. I'm not sure that there isn't some scientist that's not going to be able to find some real scientific correlation between the two. Having said that, so that's me, that's Vin as a quote scientific philosopher. On the other side of that is, God knew that he was going to take those people in a plane crash, and that's one of the things, that's one of the last things that he wanted them to leave the world.
Right.
So, you know, the car accident, it's so fascinating because we're watching this show, and in this show, this couple is leading a very, very, very dangerous lifestyle. And their lives are in danger pretty much every other episode. Like, literally in danger, guns pulled on them, the whole nine yards. But they never quit the lifestyle. And then toward the end, they get into this massive car accident. The car flips, all types of craziness. And everybody makes it out alive miraculously. And somebody goes to these people and says, listen, this is a warning from God. This is a warning from God. You have to stop. And the woman responds to him and says, this is a sign from God that he's always going to protect us. So it was just like, wow, like how people interpret the situations in life. And how people interpret massive moments in their life is so fascinating. So the priest looks at it as a warning, but this woman took it as a sort of carte blanche to do what she wanted because God was going to protect her. It's just a crazy, crazy, fascinating discussion.
I would say when I worked in, a rehab unit. It was rehab for injuries, a lot of broken hips, things like that. Every single time, it was literally 100% of the time, when the person was negative, their healing was slower. And when the person was positive, their healing was faster. Now you could say, well, maybe their healing was already on an either fast or slow process. And because it was slower, it made them negative. I don't really know which one comes first, but the people that stayed positive, they were out of there in less days. Their pain level seemed to be more tolerable. Everything was more controlled. They were able to accomplish more in PT. I thought that was bizarre. The second I saw them come onto the floor, which was, you know, right after they had basically cleared their heads after surgery, they spent, I think, one day on another floor. And then they would come up to our floor. And as soon as they came on, within 5 to 10 minutes, I knew if they were going to be there long or short.
Yeah, pretty wild. So that's an example of the correlation between positive thinking, positive speaking, and outcome.
Mm-hmm.
And to that degree, I agree. I think everybody would, no matter how skeptical you are. But what I'm talking about is, can you smell that smell? The smell of death surrounds you. The angel of death is there, sticking in you. Like the angel of death is upon you. that's something different than I'm going to beat this cancer or whatever. You know, and then you die in a plane crash, or you write a song called Ready to Die, and then you die, you know, you get killed or whatever. And the terrible thing is, the song is so good. It's such a good song. It's my favorite song of the week so far. And they didn't get the opportunity to see...
That's the album cover.
The album. I mean, they're in flames and shit in the album. SubhanAllah.
I know.
But, like, they didn't get to see who knows? Maybe they didn't get to see. I don't know. I see a pattern with all you believers. When something great happens, it's God's blessing. If something bad's happened, it's one of God's mysteries. Well, I didn't say it was mysterious. I said God knew he was going to take those people.
Yeah.
And I essentially blamed the plane crash on God. I said God took them. He knew he was going to take them in the plane crash. The Lord gives and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord is my perspective on that stuff. The specifics as to why God causes tragedies, or why God blesses people, that is equally mysterious. For example, why I am blessed with all the things that I have. The doctor told my mother I was never going to be able to have kids, and I can't stop having kids. That is a mystery, because there's other people that I was just in a forum, pro-life forum, and there's this woman who's been trying to have a child for 2 years. And it's not happening for her. Meanwhile, it's happening for me. Why I'm blessed with so many children when I wasn't even supposed to be able to have one is a mystery. And why that girl can't have kids is also a mystery. So God's blessings and God's, not necessarily cursings, but negative providences or bad providences, they're both mysterious. Mm-hmm. But what cannot be denied is that at some level it had to be God's will. Otherwise, the plane wouldn't have crashed. But good point, though, Amy, because a lot of believers would say all the blessings come from God. What I thought you were going to say is all the bad stuff is because of the devil. But you did. But yeah, the song is really, really disturbing to me. But I really like the song, and it's going into my playlist. It's a 10.5 for me.
Oh, wow.
I think that everybody needs to hear it. You know, one of the standards they have for the NFL Hall of Fame is that you cannot tell a story of the NFL without this player. And I just think you cannot tell a story of rock and roll, whatever genre this is, without this particular song, particularly, quote, Southern rock. Mm-hmm. I don't think you can tell the story of Southern rock without this band and this song in particular. That's what I really, really believe. So it's getting a 10.5 for me.
It's a 9.85 for me. I definitely think it's an important song. I think that I felt like that they were trying to... Well, the other one, the guy was just completely taken over by his alcoholism. And there was like no, you know, dying inside by St. Vitus. There was no... It seemed like that there was no escape, you know. With this one, it seems like it's a warning. It's, you know, I just came off in a totally different way, and I think probably it saved lives. So I'm definitely a fan. I'm going with the 9.85.
Yeah, really, 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 really good song.
Solid
really
10 from River.
10.5 from me. Really good song. Rest in peace to all the homies. Inshallah, we'll see them all again, inshallah. Yeah, one of these days I'm going to do like a Don Hoffman mega stream at like 4, 5, 6 o'clock at night. And that'll give you guys some perspective on my world. Because I'm still developing. I was telling Sori I'm going to create a separate anonymous channel that collates all of my various philosophies. But I'm legit afraid to do it because I don't want it to become a cult. I don't want to be another Teal Swan. All right. More on the way. Finn out.
Sori out.
Gone. All right, guys. Commercial break. We shall return.